Built in 1983 by the Gabrielle family, the Magic Fountain has been a staple in the Township of Union Center for years. The Pereza family took it over in 2016, making the ice cream and the Italian ice the same old-fashioned way, the original 18 flavors, and adding their own magic touch to new flavors. Their goal is to keep the parlor a place where friends and families gather for a few laughs and longtime memories. Meridoc Burkhardt here with our first episode of this season, Wining and Dining. And we're here with, I'm very excited about this, first of all. And we're here with Ruben Pereza. Ruben, thank you for opening our 2018 season. Very exciting.
Oh, number one.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Well, now I figured since we were opening our season and you were opening for the season, this would be an appropriate way to begin.
Yes. That's terrific.
So
I'm excited.
It's begun?
It's begun, yes. It was a long process. It was a long winter. A lot of painting and achy knees and back and tired eyes. But we're like 99% done.
Nice. And I know you opened a couple days ago. So, and it's still a little cold out. So
yeah.
But it gives you a nice transition into your main part of your season, right?
Right, right. And if you want to know, today is the first day of spring. So.
It is.
Although we wouldn't know it.
No, it does not feel like spring outside right now.
But customers that have been coming in saying, this is a sign of spring.
Right.
When they get ice cream.
That is.
They come in and they're like, when you're open, we know it's going to be getting warm.
Well, before we delve into your opening and your season, tell us a little bit about yourself. Tell us your life story, Ruben. Oh, from the very beginning, where were you born?
I hear the violins now. Well, I'm from New York.
Okay.
I was born and raised in the Bronx, and I didn't want to raise my children in New York City because at the time it was getting kind of rough.
Yeah.
So we went out and I worked in New Jersey. I worked as an IT guy.
Okay.
And it was out in Whippany, New Jersey. And I wanted to move out there, but the in-laws were like, no, let's stay a little closer to New York. And so a real estate agent that they found said, there's a nice little town called Union. I said, I never heard of it, but let's go take a look. And the first place we drove down was Stuyvesant Avenue here, with all the shops here. It reminded me of that small town USA.
Yeah.
Because coming from the city,
sure.
Something like this was just... It was beautiful. I was like, oh, this is great. This is a nice town. Let's see what we got. And the house was nice, so we bought into Union. That was back in 1994,
okay.
I want to say, 94. Oh. So yeah, so I've been living in town for over 20 years.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah. And it's, you know, town's been good to me.
How many kids?
I had three kids.
Three kids?
Yeah.
All right.
Amanda, Nicholas, and Christina.
Nice.
And... they're all in Florida, doing their thing in Florida right now.
All right.
So, yeah.
Because they're on their vacation?
No, they live there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh.
They live and work there.
Cool.
Yeah. They're all grown and gone, and they went through the union school system here, the public system, and that was, again, this town has a lot of nice things with the education and what they do with the kids here.
Yeah.
It's.
I can agree with this, because I went through the school system here, too.
Right.
Soccer, baseball, all of the shows. Mm-hmm. So I totally understand what brought you here.
Yeah.
It's what's kept me here.
Yes. Yeah. So. Not only with the schools, but what the town does with at Christmas time and the tree lighting stuff, and then the street fairs.
Well, what we had discussed off camera, we were just discussing the importance of a family foundation and a community. And belonging to, and I feel like that's what we both agreed upon, is that like we really both feel like we belong.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah.
So you lived here for a while, and then what made you decide to take over?
Well, it
was that the plan, that you wanted to own a business? And
well, my growing up, my father was a butcher.
Okay.
And he owned his own butcher shop in the Bronx, and I had a lot of fun working there. I worked the summers there, and then when I got a little bit older, I worked more hours there. But it wasn't in one of the nicest neighborhoods,
got it.
South Bronx.
Sure.
So it's But he sold the business, and then he moved to Florida and retired down there. And I miss him a lot. God bless him. You know, he passed quite a few years ago.
Mm-hmm.
But those memories of that always had in me to want to own my own place. You know, I didn't think it was going to be an ice cream shop. I always thought it was going to be a restaurant.
Okay.
I mean, for the past few years, I've been looking at restaurants, buying a restaurant off of somebody, a turnkey style. And but the ice cream shop found me because I worked at this company, a finance company, as an IT guy in down in Wall Street. And I lost my job. They got outsourced.
Sure.
So it was kind of rough. This is about 3 years ago. It's kind of rough finding a job around here. You
know, especially within that field.
In the New York, New Jersey area, yeah. It's for one job opening, 2,000 people would apply. So it was very difficult. And my wife and I wanted to go out for ice cream. And I was studying to be to get my network, technical networking
certificate.
And so she took me out for ice cream, and we went to another ice cream shop in another town. And it was a line full of 30 kids. And my wife's like, I can't deal with this. There's a magic fountain in our town. I was like, oh, that's right, let's go. So I didn't do much in the town because I worked for 12 hours a day.
Right.
And on the weekends, I didn't want to do anything. I didn't want to leave the house. And so we came here, and in the parking lot, we pull up, and the lights that were shining right on this big sign that said, for sale. Just big, it was huge. And I looked at my wife, and I was like, it's for sale. And it's an ice cream shop. And she knows that I have the biggest sweet tooth of anybody that she ever knows, okay? And we came in, and Desi, the owner here, I said, oh, so this is for sale, huh? And he was working by himself that night because it was a chilly night.
Sure.
And he said, yeah, it's for sale. And I was like, oh, okay. And we talked a little bit, and this and that happened, and
here
I am.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they're a great family, the Gabrielli family, a great family. They stayed on board when I bought the shop.
Yeah, and to transition.
Yeah. Yep, exactly.
Which is also important too, because you know, you want that.
Yeah.
Especially as a place as iconic as this is, and as part of Union Center as this is. It's almost like they're introducing you to the community at the same time.
Yeah,
and it was a family business, so I could totally understand that.
Yeah, absolutely. Magic Fountain's not a franchise, so it's privately owned. Even though there's a couple of them around, there's Nick who owns the one out in Summit, and there's Jimmy who owns the one in Bayonne, and I met those guys, and they also helped me when I bought the place.
Well, because to go back to what we talked about earlier, the idea of family.
Right.
I mean, at a community, it's, you know.
Exactly, and those two places are family run. So we're people think that this is a franchise, but it's not.
Right.
It's privately owned, and we all kind of are connected, so we are kind of like family
team.
As well. Yeah.
Cool.
And with the Gabrielli family, Desi had given me his recipes for his 18 flavors of ice cream. And so
I
kept it the same.
With all the 18 flavors, plus maybe you've given yourself a little flexibility.
So I have to, I have
develop.
To expand.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I went to a ice cream university for
that's pretty cool.
for a week, and they taught me how to make ice cream as well.
Mm-hmm.
So I took a little bit of old school style with new school, and I started coming up with my own flavors.
Okay. Well, I have some ideas, maybe off camera, we could talk about some of the ideas that I have.
Oh, okay.
I don't know, maybe just throwing it out there.
I'll get my notebook that
I was full
of all the ideas.
I was giving myself
customers.
A little tour, and I noticed, I was like, he's lacking a lot of peanut butter type stuff. I need some more peanut butter.
Well, you see,
butter.
We're just opening, so I haven't gotten to the chocolates yet.
All right.
But I do have a chocolate peanut butter nut.
Okay. All right. Well, so let's talk a little bit before, because obviously my favorite part of this show is going in the back, and I know you have a wonderful surprise for us in the back kitchen. It's something we're going to create. But let's just talk a little bit about your seasons. So earlier you were telling me that you were away on vacation. You were in the Bahamas.
Yep. Went
so
to,
Bahamas. Your tan is still around. It's still
long
there.
Gone. Yeah, I don't know about that.
I still see it.
I think that's because I'm on camera.
Yeah.
Well, that's because the Spanish, that's the Latin.
Because of all the makeup that Natalie put on both of us. Right. As we're let's just, because that's part of what gravitated me to using you for this opening show was the fact that, you know, you're opening, you've had this off season, and now there's like there's excitement and there's a lot of preparation and things. What has it been like? Have you gotten used to the opening? Because this is going to be your third opening or second opening?
It's 2.5. All right. Right. We came in July of 2016. Mm-hmm. And so our first opening was last year, which we didn't really do much in the shop. It was just, we closed for 2 months and then we reopened.
Got it.
We had a longer season that time.
Sure.
And so this year we had a long layoff because I wanted
How many months was this layoff?
It was from the end of November to just this weekend in March. And so there was a lot of planning and prepping and painting. And
I wish we would have talked about this.
Yeah, I could have used the help.
I'm really good with the 2.5-inch brush. I got a real ambidextrous. I could paint with both hands at the same time.
I was supposed to paint one wall.
Yeah.
Well, I was supposed to paint the hallway.
Yeah, but you can't just paint one wall, because once you paint one wall, then your focus is going to be on everything else.
Yeah. Well, yeah. I mean, Donna, my wife Donna, I told her, how does the hallway look? She goes, oh, it looks good. I says, what if we just paint this wall, too? And then she said,
that wall looks great, but the rest of the place, I don't know.
She said, well, if you're going to go there, you might as well go in there and then in the back. So, you know, it is soothing when you're doing the strokes and you meditate and you're just thinking and
hopefully
and
listening to some music.
And of course, I work with music and when we make ice cream, I'm going to have some music on because I can't make ice cream without music.
That's fine.
You got to have the rhythm.
Do you have a special song planned for this this particular ice cream?
I put on disco music because I'm a child of the 70s. So I got some. A little bit of disco, so it's random. Whatever pops up on
That's
disco.
Fine. I'm a random dancer too, so you may even like see some random dance moves.
Well, I sing a little bit too, so good. I don't know if the customer. Nobody ever complained, so.
No.
Maybe a song
it's because
and
dance they can't, because their mouths are full with ice cream.
That's right.
Right?
That's
no one's going to complain.
I keep them quiet.
All right, well, we're gonna take a quick break, guys, and then we're going to be back. We're going to be in the kitchen creating something magical. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll be right back.
People think I'm trash, but they're wrong. Today I'm just an aluminum can, but one day I could be a stadium.
I'm from Blue Hood Stone Barns.
We brought a meal for you, and I'm here to serve it to you.
Okay, great. Come in.
Zucchini carbonara, made from zucchini that was harvested earlier this morning.
Again?
Oh. Hey, Dan Barber.
You have room for a little bit more?
Come on in.
Rochettes, the sausage. So when we made that zucchini carbonara, you know, they're the end pieces of the zucchini, and then the cores that we cut away, not to mention zucchini flour.
Usually those get thrown out. We use them to create an entire second dish.
Does that, oh.
Again?
I'm here to bring you your third course. It's the vines from your zucchini.
We'll have a little zucchini stem pasta. A different experience of zucchini. When we start to think differently about our food, we can get a lot more out of it.
This is delicious.
What do you think we can make out of this?
40% of food in America is never eaten. Cook it, store it, share it. Visit savethefood.com.
And we're back. Magic Fountain, me, Ruben, we're in his workshop. I'm very excited. I have no idea what we're gonna create. So Ruben, before you surprise me with this delicious ice cream that we're gonna create today, let's talk a little bit specifically about the ice cream making process when you open. So already, how many ice creams have you already created since you've opened?
You know, that's not a number I keep track of.
Got it.
I just do.
You just go.
I just go.
So now, do you like create a new ice cream every single day until?
No,
like...
I make quite a few ice creams a day.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, right. I keep going. I try and make in bulk.
Right.
Because something like Oreo, I can't just make one batch. I have to make a couple of batches. That's a top seller.
Sure.
You know, so I have a couple. I have quite a few top sellers: the rum raisin, the Oreo, the cookie dough, the cake batter.
So opening, you need to make sure that you have all of these. Because I know earlier when we were discussing, you said you still hadn't made some of the chocolates
right.
and things like that.
Yeah.
And is that just because you haven't gotten to them yet in the process, or?
Well, no, and. Folks that are on our Facebook page would know that we had an issue, a freezer issue.
Ah.
So I couldn't go ahead and make everything that I wanted to make. So it kind of delayed me. Right now, if I had opened the shop, I'd just be sitting back and helping out with customers.
Right.
So right now, I'm a little bit behind in ice cream making.
Got it. I love ice cream making. I'm really excited. So why don't we specifically... I'm ready. I want you to tell me what are we creating today, what are we making, and then you tell me what to do, and it'll be my first ice cream. I'm super excited. And if you guys can't hear it in the background, we are listening to some really cool music, because you did say you need to make ice cream and listen to music.
I gotta listen to music, yeah.
Is there a different song for like a different flavor? Like if you're like, oh, I'm gonna make an Oreo, he was like, I have to listen to something a little more hard rock. Or any musical theater?
You know, it depends on my mood. Okay. Today is a disco day.
Yeah,
sometimes
feel it.
I have some nostalgic jazz, some old jazz.
Mm.
But anything that I can sing to while I'm working is
cool.
Is helps me make the ice cream.
All right, cool.
Puts a little love in and a little bit of pizzazz into
the
ice cream.
I like the song that we're listening to right now. It's very disco, very 70s.
Yeah.
So what are we making to the 70s music? Tell me, what are we doing?
Cannoli.
Cannoli.
Cannoli chocolate chip.
Nothing says cannoli like the 70s. Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah. And this is my favorite thing to make because it's there's a lot of ingredients into this,
right.
and it's an old-fashioned recipe.
Okay.
So it's not just adding a flavor and into cream. Now we're adding a variable of ingredients.
Right.
We got ricotta cheese.
So as you introduce it, I will show it and introduce it.
Yep. And we're using a Gilbani. It's a very dry ricotta cheese.
Okay.
So it's
is this just half of a portion rather than a full portion because of your specific?
No, we added more into the mix, so I can't give off
the TV guys. You don't see everything.
Can't give you the whole recipe.
All right, so may I?
Yes.
All right.
You may. So we have a bucket here full of our premium plain hard mix.
Okay. Wonderful.
Yep, I'll take that. And you can go ahead and put that in. Now I just found out that there is a place in Union that makes cheese here over near King College.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
So is that where you got it?
No.
Okay.
But I'm going to get in touch with them because I like to keep things local if I can.
As you should.
Yeah.
One of my favorite words is ricotta. Say it with me, everyone.
Ricotta.
Ricotta. Everyone at home. Very nice, guys. Very nice. Oh, see, I don't even really need it.
Yeah, see how it just slides right out.
Yeah.
Good.
All right. So
okay.
I'm done with this too, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Now we can do the sugar.
The sugar?
Yep.
Sugar. I love all of the sounds of all of the refrigerators and freezers going on. It's like a choir.
Well, it's music to my ears.
If
it weren't,
it is.
We'd be in trouble. And lastly, we have vanilla.
Ah, vanilla. Smells delicious.
It's like a bourbon.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful.
That's it. And I'll mix it for you.
You're gonna mix it?
I'll mix it. While this music is going. That's mm-hmm. the way you get the.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you know what's gonna happen while you mix it and you listen to music? I'm gonna go take a little VIP tour of all of the different flavors that you have out front. I believe Jessica's gonna give me a tour. So guys, you don't wanna miss this next part because I'm gonna sample a bunch of flavors. It's gonna be great. And then we're gonna come back and maybe we'll sample or?
Yep, absolutely.
Yeah? Yep. All right, guys. Tune in, we'll be back.
Ooh!
And we're back, and I have a VIP tour with Jessica.
Hi.
Hi, Jess. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. So, Jess, how long have you worked here? Tell us a little bit about your history with Magic Fountain.
All right. So, I've been coming here since I was a kid. I live down the street. I come for ice cream all the time. And then one day I came in with my little sister, and the old owner, Fernando, was like, "Hey, Jessica, are you looking for a job?" And I was like, "Sure, why not?"
Oh, cool.
And I've been working here for 3 years, and I love it. It's the best job I can get. I love it so much.
Yeah, my brother briefly worked at a ice cream spot, and
that's so cool.
He ate a lot of ice cream. He probably just got paid just in ice cream. Love you, Steele. All right, so we're gonna do a little VIP tour. I just want you to talk me through what's happening back here. What is it like when a customer comes and says, "I don't know what to get, what should I get?"
It's hard to like, because you don't know what everybody likes to eat. So like, some people like certain flavors, other people like other ones. But
all right. So is this where we would start?
Yeah. So these are like our like sweeter flavors. There's like cake batter, Nutella, cannoli, cotton candy. Like, I think that this is more of like the kids section. There's Oreo.
So this is my section then, if you're saying.
Yeah, it's, probably.
It's nice. Okay. Can I have a little sample of the cake batter, please?
Sure.
Woo-hoo-hoo. Starting off right.
Here you go.
These are so tiny. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's definitely one of our more popular flavors.
It's very battery.
Yeah. And then over here we have pistachio, butter pecan, cookie dough, vanilla, mint chocolate chip, banana.
What's your favorite?
I definitely like the Oreo or the coconut, which is over there.
Okay.
Probably one of my favorites. And over here we usually have gelatos. They're imported from Italy. They're really good, very popular. Here we have some Italian ices. Usually there's a lot more. Right now we just have mango,
well, you guys,
lemon.
You guys just opened, so. And then we just have more?
Yeah, so this is where we keep most of the chocolate flavors. We have Choreo, which is chocolate Oreo. We have Java chocolate chip, which is like coffee with chocolate chips. It's really fun. And then there's chocolate chip, which is just like for those chocolate lovers.
Yeah, see, I'm a peanut butter man myself. I have like a peanut butter like problem. No, I'm like, I will go and I will just like whatever peanut butter topping you have, I want that.
Cool. And then we also have some fat-free, sugar-free options. There's chocolate, vanilla, and strawberry.
Nice.
Yeah.
Well, I want to come back over here. I want to ask you a question. So what happens here, have you ever put your face underneath this and turned the machine on and just let the nobody is watching right now, so nobody knows. Ruben doesn't know.
No, I've never done that.
Maybe before I leave.
Maybe.
Tell me, I mean, you must have a lot of people who come in here and a lot of fun things that go on. Do you have a story in particular that stands out?
One time a milkshake exploded on me in front of like it was really busy. It was like a hot summer night. Like everybody in the world was here.
That's great.
And like it just exploded all over me. I was drenched in butter pecan milkshake and like it was terrible.
So did you work in the same outfit?
Oh yeah, I kept going. I was like, the show must go on. Like, I have to finish doing this. I was the only person working. I was like...
Were you sampling it as...
No. Now every time I smell butter pecan, I think about that. I'm like, no.
See, that's an amazing, amazing memory. And,
yeah. And there's a nice picture of it, framed.
Well, we'll have to take a look. But I hope you guys can come here and maybe have an amazing memory like Jess's. Thanks for chatting, Jess.
Thank you.
We'll be back.
Hi, I'm Peter, and there's nothing I love more than sharing vegetables with my friends.
Come on in, help yourself to anything.
That's why we give our food the utmost respect it deserves. Did you know there are simple steps we can all take to help save food? You can cook it, store it, even share it. Just don't waste it. Because when it comes to food, better ate than never. To learn more, visit savethefood.com.
Hello, welcome to Magic Fountain. How may I help you? Just kidding, we're back. We were just making some delicious cannoli ice cream. Unfortunately, Ruben kicked me out of his workshop. Allegedly, there is some secret brotherhood and order of the cone,
and I was not able to be part of it.
Here's your peanut butter milkshake.
Oh my God, Jess, thank you so much.
Can I get you anything else?
No, I'm good.
All right, good.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
I love it here.
Oh, what is this?
What is what?
Milkshake.
I'm just I'm sampling everything. I feel like a kid in an ice cream parlor. Wait, I am a child in an ice cream parlor. It's all right, Ruben. I have room. I'll put this aside.
Well, here's your cannoli. That's the one you made?
Yes. Well, we made together.
Okay.
Although you didn't, you had to do some other things in the background, which I was not able to take part of. The secret order of the cone, I believe?
Secret order of the cone.
Mmm. Yeah. Uh-huh.
Good?
It is very good.
Thank you. This is our signature, this is my signature recipe. We do it from scratch, as we all saw. And this is most popular flavor that people buy here. And I can't keep enough of it here. In fact, I got a couple of restaurants that want to start serving this at their restaurant.
Nice.
Yeah. So it goes well in an Italian restaurant, and I got two Italian restaurants that are interested in me producing some ice cream for them.
I don't even know what to say. You know what my favorite part is? I mean, the flavor is delicious altogether, but it's all the little tiny chocolate nugget bombs that every once in a while as you're eating, it's like a little tiny, like,
bink. Yeah.
Ruben, this is just so good. I feel like it's never ending. I feel like it's just...
It's bottomless sometimes.
Ruben, one of the things I noticed was this Union VIP card. What is all that about?
Oh, yeah. Magic Fountain is part of the Union VIP Club, okay, where it's we give money back to the customer,
okay,
the township. It's a promotion that the township's doing where you come in, you buy something, we swipe your card, you get money back, goes towards your taxes, whether you own or rent anything in Union.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Well, that sounds like a great opportunity.
So we're giving back. We're paying your taxes, so to speak. And we're proud to be one of the participants of the Union VIP.
Very nice, very nice.
So, awesome. And we have the cards here too, so if somebody comes in, they don't have a card, we'll give you a card. It's very simple to sign up.
Well, Ruben, I want to thank you.
Oh, thank you.
For allowing us to have our season premiere episode, and also this is your season premiere too.
Yes.
So you and I have had a lot of fun together.
Yeah.
We had we've hosted an ice cream eating competition, yes, together.
So yes, that was so much fun.
I hope there's more of these in our future.
Yes, we do. We're going to be in it this year again.
Nice.
And we're just, just follow us on Facebook.
Yeah.
Magic Fountain Union Creamery, which is our new name, Magic Fountain Union Creamery.
Okay.
Yeah, I changed it at the Union Creamery because we make homemade ice cream here. We're a creamery.
Yeah. This is so good.
So we're always posting things on Facebook or when we're doing something because I like to plan out about a week or two in advance because, it depends a lot on the weather. So.
Do you want a little bit? No?
Yeah. No, you enjoy it.
Okay. Well, guys, thank you for joining us on our first season premiere episode of Wining and Dining. From me, Meridoc Burkhart, and my man Ruben, please come out and support a great locally owned business right here in Union Center. That's our episode, and thanks again.